If you are heading into this weekend thinking the best way to get through this pandemic is just to keep calm and garden on, I'm so with you. And so is our next guest this morning. We are learning how to grow our own victory garden. Now, gardening expert Antonio Valente is joining us to explain. A lot of people have not heard of this idea before, a victory garden. Where did it come from? And also, good morning to you. I'm liking your COVID coif, by the way.
Thank you, Anne-Marie. Good morning. Now, full disclosure before we begin, I'm not wearing any pants.
Oh. You would so be you guest know. Number four. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay. So I'm not alone. Yeah, so the Victory Garden, during the Second World War, it was sort of hoped that Canadians could sort of start a garden in their own backyard, start a few of their own vegetables, and in time of crisis, they could become a little bit more self-sufficient. So, you know, fast forward to 2020, here we are in a very different crisis, and, you know, the Victory Garden has been trending on social media again.
I love that. This concept that came up after the world wars to, you know, supply your own food and help fill out rations. I guess you're right. It's very timely. Okay, let's start with the do's, starting with sunlight. Do we want shade? Yeah. Do we want sun? What do we want to do a successful victory garden?
Yes, the do's. So generally speaking, for fruits and vegetables, you want full sun. A minimum of 6 to 8 hours is ideal. And if you're not sure, there are apps on your phone that you can now download. Light meter app that you can take out to your garden, and it'll help you measure the light. It'll tell you if you've got enough light for fruits and vegetables to properly grow and fruit.
Yeah. All right, secondly, how important is soil? You want us to get our soil tested. How do we do that?
Yeah, so this is super important if you're starting somewhere new. You want to get a soil test, and if you head to the Ministry of Agriculture's website, they will give you a number of locations where you can send in a soil sample. Or now at the hardware store, these kits are even available there, so you can do the test yourself, and they'll tell you what's in your soil and what you need to add to it in case you're lacking nutrients.
Oh, okay, so when it comes to the plants themselves then, am I buying seeds? Am I planting actual plants? What's the best thing to do to get the best garden?
Okay, good question. So generally speaking, any root crops or salad greens, you're gonna wanna start them by seed. You get the most bang for your buck with these types of vegetables when you start from seed, and it's super cost effective. And then anything else, you can start with transplants. So we got here some eggplants, we've got some peppers. Anything else, you can start with transplants.
All right, we are going to have to put up the list of don'ts up on our website. Antonio, it was really great to see you. I'm so excited for people to start their victory gardens.
I know, Anne-Marie. Thanks. This is the weekend for it.
Yeah, thanks. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.